Hello, world. Mr. Resistor here, continuing our alpha journey. And, looks like today we're doing more scanning. Got two wormholes, five signatures. Which is cool, because that's what we're set up for anyway. What else do we have today? Send that to the heck. And we get a little scanning bonus. That sounds good. All right. All right, one down.
Drive active.
Hopefully the metaluminal storm hasn't moved on. And my route is still gonna take me to the center of it.
Warp drive active.
All right, so we jump to a player-owned station to get the benefit of tethering. As long as it's got the little arrow and not the slash. Alright, that gives us some protection. Usually it's good to have a safe spot saved also, but I'm feeling lazy today, and there's no orange in local, so One down.
Warp drive active. Warp drive active.
Well, it looks like I got some competition today. All right. So I think I'm gonna head back to Olbra. Because if I remember correctly, got a ship in the oven.
Drive active.
I don't know a ton about lasers because I haven't flown many of our ships. I believe pulse lasers are basically equivalent to autocannons. Warp scrambler. Oh, they've only got two medium slots. That makes sense because Amar are usually armor slots, so they'd have or armor tanks, so they'd have more low slots. Especially with the armor plate, I believe that slows you down. So, yeah, I see what he means about only having the afterburner. You'd really want to have a MWD in order to get some decent speed out of that thing. Which, I mean, you kind of want MWD in faction warfare anyway, because even if you're just doing the sights, like those faction warfare rats are usually pretty fast.
Mark drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
That's not a terrible fit. I like missiles in the other slot for the extra damage, or rockets, I mean, for the additional damage, but Nosferatu, probably useful. Interesting. Reduced activation cost. Autocannons don't have an activation cost, so of course, I guess he's not really losing much there. And what he's getting is a pretty decent armor tank. A lot of cap. So, if he's able to get in range, he can keep these applied for a long time. But that's a big if, because the Mars ships tend to be slower, and he's got no prop mods. I mean, Hook's not an amateur, though. I expect they knew what they were doing with that fit. I don't know that I've ever flown a Mollus. That's interesting. All right. Anyway. Go, Stabber fleet issue. All right. Well, I think that's going to be it for me for today. So until next time, have a good one.